That is such a comfort sometimes, just to have somebody's arms around you, don't you think?
No.
Come on, it feels good.
It does not feel good, it hurts.
Oh. Like a cut or a bruise?
Like a burn. Like when you go outside and your feet freeze, and then you come back in and they thaw out. It's like that. It's almost exactly like that.
Same with everybody?
Oh, not really with Bianca.
Ankahi Kahaniya came out last week on Netflix, and it was one out of the three stories that caught my attention the most. The first short, directed by Ashwani Iyer Tiwari and starring Abhishek Banerjee, is also quite similar to another movie that came out in 2007 called Lars and the Real Girl, written by Nancy Oliver. Also, both stories bear a lot of resemblance to the Greek figure Pygmalion and takes inspiration from Ovid's poem Metamorphoses, in which Pygmalion was a sculptor who fell in love with a statue he had carved. Both stories cover a shy and lonely man finding love and solace in an inanimated object. While in Ankahi Kahaniya, Pradeep falls for a clothing store female mannequin which he names Pari, Lars decides to get himself anatomically correct life-size female doll called Bianca. However, both the relationships develop without much physical intimacy and rather through one-sided conversations. In Ankahi Kahaniya, Pradeep has moved to a big city to earn more money while he puts his whole heart into his work. It has led to him leaving a quite reclusive life. His loneliness is made even more prominent when compared to the people around him, like his colleague who leaves work early to meet his girlfriend or his roommate who is always on the phone with his partner. While running an errand for his boss, he is asked to pick up a new female mannequin for the shop display, the very first one. Pradeep is instantly enamored by her and shy at first starts talking to her eventually. While their meeting is nothing short of a meet cute, Lars does not start that way. Instead of a chance encounter, Lars chooses to bring Bianca into his life. Lars consciously or subconsciously is aware of his shortcomings to form a human connection and thus takes this step. And Bianca from the very beginning is introduced as Lars's girlfriend. A thought that initially disgusts most people around him. Pradeep falls for Pari because he is lonely in a big city and has failed to yet make a friend or a confidant in the city. Lars is a shy and secluded man who has never had a connection with another human being ever. He defined others' touch as burning and probably chose Bianca because he could never imagine himself having any intimacy with another human being. Both decided to relieve themselves of the loneliness through these objects. But that is not as absurd of a concept. Both stories show examples of such relationships which are much more acceptable in our society. For when Lars's colleague gets extremely upset when another co-worker puts her teddy bear in a noose, or when his action figures go missing, Pradeep talks about how his grandfather loved his radio and his family carried on the tradition even after his grandfather died. It is normal in culture to attach emotion to inanimate objects as long as that emotion is not sexual or cannot be interpreted as sexual. An adult is alright when they are attached to childhood toys or any other object, but it becomes troublesome when they start showing love, intimacy or compassion to something that society has deemed unethical. Pradeep is the one responsible for cleaning up Pari and dressing her. He keeps his attraction hidden from his co-workers. This is a testament to his self-awareness. He understands the unnatural behavior of his situation and knows well enough to not expose it. Lars, on the other hand, is suffering from delusion. He doesn't see Bianca as a lifeless object. Pradeep's employer finds out that he had been showing affection towards the mannequin after hours. He takes her out to roam around the city and dances with her in an empty store when everyone has left. He is even oftentimes caught by his co-worker talking to Pari as he wipes her down. All this leads to his employer banning him from going near the mannequin. In Lars's case, he lives in a small community that genuinely cares for him, and this care is then transferred to Bianca. They pretend that she is a human girl and interact with her just like that. Apprehensive at first, the community quickly creates a space for Bianca, so much so that she starts developing a life apart from Lars. This causes a rift between the two. As soon as Lars realizes that she is developing traits that are not assigned by Lars, he is quick to blame Bianca for not giving him her time. But it is the individual's reaction towards these circumstances is what differs. While Pradeep's feelings are discarded, he accepts his fate and agrees to admire her from a distance. But when his co-worker is asked to change her clothes or when he chooses to dress her in a more Western attire which Pradeep disapproves of, Pradeep is quick to blame his co-worker rather than asking Pari. Lars at least allowed Bianca to develop flaws, even if it came out of his disapproval. But Pradeep has placed Pari at a pedestal, the drawback of which is that he does not think she has any authority and is at the mercy of her handler. He cherishes her and admires her, but has chosen to give her a sad life of being handled by the men in charge. Of course, a full feature runtime allows Lars and the real girl to tackle the mental issues and past traumas that lead to Lars developing feelings for a sex doll. We do not get any such exploration for Pradeep, only that he is lonely in a big city and has failed to find a romantic partner. Once Lars starts developing stronger relations with other people, his dependence on Bianca reduces. And once he starts developing romantic feelings for another girl, the very next day he decides that Bianca is dying from a terminal illness. Lars very clearly had abandonment issues, and since Bianca's existence was completely dependent on him, she would never have a reason to leave. Once that started changing, and Lars too started getting more independent from Bianca, he let go of her on his terms. The decision for Pradeep was made by the employer. After coming back from his village, he finds out that Pari had been sold to another shop, and even though he is now about to be married to his childhood friend and won't likely be lonely, the moment of closure is only a few minutes of dialogue between Pradeep and Pari. He explains his loneliness to her and why he started talking to her. His feelings for her are still there. We know it from his distress on seeing Pari missing from the shop, but aware that there is no future for him with Pari, he lets her go, at least in appearances. Pari was never Pradeep's to begin with. She was always his employer's property. Hence, it was not his choice on where she moves on to. Even in their conversations, he never showed ownership, not to be confused with jealousy. Lars had the independence to kill Bianca because he was the reason she was brought to life. Yet, one had a chance to close a chapter in his life and move on the way he wanted to, while the decision made by Pradeep was driven by his societal circumstances and less by his conscience. In Ankahi Kahaniya, we are with Pradeep and his love story. We are watching it from the inside of the bubble these two share. While in Lars and the Real Girl, we are watching a relationship from the outside. We are watching it with the townspeople and sharing their thoughts. It's no longer romantic, rather it starts as disturbing, completely aware that this is not normal behavior. It is a story of someone so scared of other humans that he would rather get a doll made and have conversations with her. One is a blossoming romance while the other is an exploration of a relationship. Yet being so close to Pradeep's love story and watching it take form, we are left with more questions than answers. Why did Pradeep feel the need to bring a statue to life? Why did he never make any friends, and why Pari and not any other mannequin he must have seen around him? One can only wonder if this shot was given a treatment of a full feature, it had been able to answer these questions. Subscribe for more movie analysis, and if you like the video then press the like button and share it with your friends. Let me know other Hindi movies that you would like to be analyzed compared to their Western counterparts.